Rabbit, rabbit, white rabbit. Oh, look, a new episode. Before I begin, I'd like to give a quick lesson of video game jargon. So, if you kids would make your way to your seats, we can begin. Now, when it comes to making a video game, there are two main groups that are involved. The first is the developer, the group that makes the game, and the second is the publisher, who pays the developer to make the game and handles the finer details, such as copyright management, disc printing, and advertising. Sometimes publishers have their own development houses, and sometimes developers work on their own. But for the most part, the developers work with or for the publisher, depending on how the development team was paid. Now remember, the publisher pays for the game, and the developer makes it. I say this because when I first heard about Rabbit, a relatively unknown fighting game, everyone kept saying that it was made by Electronic Arts. As you could expect, my brain crossed itself over for a moment. How could anything that EA has ever made fall so far along the wayside, especially in the 90s, since that company was a juggernaut back in the day? Because of my confusion, I looked for info on the game, and I found out that the game was developed by a company called Aorn, which seems to have fallen off of the earth, and Electronic Arts Victor, a now defunct branch of EA which was established as an Asian branch of the company. I found myself in a difficult position. The game was recommended to me by someone who likes this series, and I hastily agreed because of them sprites. The character designs are atypical due to the fact that they look less like the typical stoic fighter that you'd see in such games, and more like something out of an action manhwa. Also, each character in the roster has an animal spirit, and they can summon them at specific times, somewhat like the stand system from JoJo's Bizarre Adventure. However, I was honestly worried that the game would simply be too underdeveloped, too simple, for me to cover in this series. Yes, I remember that I covered Joy Mecha Fight, but I was worried that it would be even simpler than that. Fortunately, I was wrong. Rabbit not only has great sprite work, but a solid foundation of mechanics to back it up. It's a four-button setup, with weak and hard punches and kicks. All characters have a universal overhead attack, performed by pressing weak and hard punch. And there are character-specific chains that can be used. Also, most characters have at least one command move. Said moves can also be coupled into chain combos as well, along with special moves and supers. You can block attacks on the ground and in the air, and deflect attacks by pressing light punch and light kick. Rather than giving some type of frame advantage, this causes the opponent to stagger backwards, which allows the player to attack. It can also quickly be comboed into in what's known as a technical blow. One of the defining features of the game is the spirit meter. It works somewhat like a standard 3-level meter, but has two additional features. The first is the ability to summon your character's specific animal spirit, which is performed by pressing both punch buttons and the light kick button. When summoned, the spirit floats overhead and a timer appears at the bottom of the screen. As time goes on, the timer decreases until the spirit disappears. While the spirit is summoned, players can use it to perform a specific attack by pressing the same three buttons or enter the motion for their character's super. Some spirits also affect their character's movement in different ways, such as weighing them down enough to prevent them from jumping high, doubling their hits, or allowing them to glide through the air. The second feature of the spirit meter is to use the supers of other characters from time to time. In story mode, once you defeat an opponent, you claim their spirit as your own, and you can use them in a limited fashion. And in versus mode, all the other spirits are available to you at any time from the start of the round. The general command is holding down forward and pressing the weak punch, weak kick, and hard punch buttons. Although, moving forward, down, and down forward works just as well. This will allow you to use another character's super, but each super can only be used once per round, and the normal restrictions for specific moves still apply. For example, the Hawk's super move can only be performed in the air, so your character would have to jump. The different supers are displayed at the bottom of the screen, which shows what spirits are available to you at the time, and they can be shuffled through by quickly tapping down, although getting to a specific one is a bit too clunky to do on the fly. The spirit meter doesn't really change the tone of a match, but when used effectively, it can at least bolster a player's offense or defense. I've mentioned this before, but it bears repeating. The game has some wonderful animation, especially when you consider that the game was released in 1997 by a small subdivision of a company. The amount of detail placed into the sprites is impressive, and even if the designs are somewhat jarring to look at, most people should be able to appreciate the sprite work that's present in this game. Then again, animation is one thing that often goes unnoticed in fighting games, and it's rarely mentioned unless people want to argue about which fighting game has better graphics than any other given fighting game, so maybe I'm giving people too much credit here. In the end though, Rabbit is a decent if somewhat offbeat fighting game, with a solid system of mechanics and fluid animation. Maybe if Aorn had survived, they might have been able to develop the game further, but at least they went out with one decent game under their belt.